invitation. Thank you very much for coming and covering this event. I'm not going to make any statement, but I'm straight away open to any questions that you may have.
Govinda Paul, sir, you seen, sir, here?
Yeah.
Sir, we've seen this Sujwa attack recently, and there seems to be a trend for targeting the security and stuff. The AFK was also targeted. So what kind of major
is concern? I will cover it in two parts. Firstly, it's a frustrated enemy who does involve in such activities when he is not able to face you on the borders. So it is but natural that when he is on the receiving end, he looks for easier alternative. While immediately behind the borders, we have strengthened ourselves and we are very well prepared. But when you come to the little hinterland, like the areas of, say, Udhampur or Sanjuan or any other place, it's like a peace station for all of us where you cannot have the same sort of a security situation to thwart this, which happens once in a way. When he really not able to do anything in the borders, then he tries to address it. So we address it in 2 to 3 different ways. As far as the borders and the immediate threat is concerned, where he could sneak in and then do some action, like in Pazanjori and other places, we are very well prepared. I must tell you that since the time Uri happened, we have spent almost 364 crores on different heads to build up our security of the softer elements which are behind, especially whether it's a fence or some smart component along with the fence, and also getting your acts together as far as surveillance is concerned, the central duty is concerned, your drills and other things are concerned, and intelligence, of course. But when you come to the depth, you all know that Indian Army has got a very large number of such small units spread all across the country. So it is very difficult to do it immediately. Yes, we have prioritized the areas which are vulnerable, which needs immediate attention. So therefore, the government has also earmarked certain funds, and that's flowing in, notwithstanding what recently has been said. But we are already working on, we have different funds flowing from different heads, which we have the authority to do it, and we have done it. And what additionally comes from the government, it's a bonus for us, and I'm sure we will be able to not only have a physical lens, but we'll look at technology-assisted one. Because you can't have manpower-intensive surveillance of the area. You will need the manpower on the boots on the ground, on the borders.
Arun Sharma, Indian Express.
You know, when we are looking at the terrorism as per se, as a whole, we look at three things. One, we need to stop any infiltration taking place. Because that's where the adversary pushes the terrorists from across the border. That we need to stop. Second, in the hinterland, whosoever is already there, we need to eliminate them. And the third is capability to induce the locals, which has been the latest trend for the last couple of years, that we need to arrest. If you address all three, then you will attain success. If any one of them is not really playing up, then you are going to be not as successful as it, one would like it to. So in this particular last year, 2017, we focused on the leadership of the terrorists, and you all know that we were able to eliminate large number of leadership. Then of course the terrorists, we eliminated them. But to our real concern, the local terrorists taking up the arms continue to increase. You know, there is large number of reasons for that, and you all are very well aware of it, whether it is social, economic, political, religious, you name a thing, it has got some connotation. If you look at the people who join, who take up arms, at least these 219 of them over there, if you look at them, you can put it into 3-4 categories. So some of them, all are in the age group of 30 and less, and majority in the area of 20 to 30. And all those past 12 standard, and almost 50 to 60% belong to the poor family, and unemployed is another 50, 60% of these people. So this is the category of people who are getting influenced, and how they get influenced is a large number. But one major factor that we need to do is, if you are able to address the terrorists, you eliminate the terrorists, you ensure the overgrown workers are also equally targeted. These two factors, if you're able to address, I think it will slowly calm down. This increase, I would attribute to, I think, post-Quran one is that euphoria people had and the social media, which really played up this issue. I think that is the reason it continued. For it to come, the curve to come down will take a while. I firmly believe if we are able to continue with this and put other measures to engage the youth in the JNK, I think we should be able to arrest it. But it's not a real concern for us, because the training they have, the type of, they don't have weapons. So ultimately, how they're going to impact us is not really of a concern. But yes, even in one individual joining is a concern at a larger scale, larger picture. That's why we need to even resist even one person joining. In this, I would say that the society at large, the parents, have to really be involved in this whole process, because we have seen the process did start. We had about 68 of them surrendering, and one in this year already, and they all came voluntarily. And I think a lot of parents also put out a call for them to shun violence and then come onto the mainstream. I feel that this is the need of the hour. We have to get the society at large to play a larger part, and of course the parents. I think if everybody does join and find that the futility of these young people taking up arms, you all know out of this, 33 of them were eliminated and about 12 more were either apprehended or surrendered. So you can see about 40% of these people, 30% of these people have already been eliminated, and the lifespan is about 6 to 7 months. So I think the faster they understand the futility of taking up arms, I think it is better. And I think we will find some solution to this. I think we need to continue with it, and we should be able to get into control. See, the people of JNK and the Valley, yesterday they have shown, I think it's a testimony for all those who are wanting to communalize it. I think a small stint in the armed forces would not be a bad thing. I think if any of you have visited any of our formation, even here in Udhampur, if you go, wherever are religious places there, it's a Sarva Dharamsthal. Where you can go to Badami Bagh camp, you have one. We have one here in Udhampur. I have one in my residence itself, where all the religious deities are there. So we take on the religion of our troops. We do not communalize any of them. It is only for people who don't know the inside of the functioning of the armed forces. They're the ones who are actually making these statements. I think they need to really visit all of us and then see how we put everything aside and we live together, and we really do not look at any one religion from the other. That's the first part. And as far as your second part of the question is concerned, see, I'm heading the Northern Command, and I can say with confidence that issue of Aditya has not dented the morale of my troops, not even a bit, not even an iota. I can say with confidence, because I do meet them, I move around, I speak to my command through my commanders, I get the pulse of it. I can say it just not dented the morale at all. Because, as I mentioned, we are very clear, and our intentions are very clear. I think the deeds are there to speak. The last 1 year, have we found any human rights cases taking place? I think that's a direction which has gone from me to the entire command of mine. You will not find anyone willfully indulging in any of them. So therefore, our intentions are correct, so nothing to really worry. And secondly, it's a case which is sub judice, and the Honorable RM made a statement, and the government is totally behind, government and the Ministry of Defense is totally behind the soldiers and the armed forces. That's a statement, I think the RM made it. I think we must take it in the right spirit. I feel that Aditya's case is subjudice, it will take its course, but it hasn't really been to the morale of the Indian Army. I don't feel that we really need to do any tit for tat. We are very well in a dominating position here. We are playing to our strategy and we'll continue to do that. And I want to assure all of you who are here that we are not going to cow down to any of these small incidents taking place, these fines and other things trying to put us off. We are not going to derail from our main course of action that we have chalked out for ourselves. जो भी मेरे नीचे कमांड में आते हैं मैं सबको एक नज़र से देखता हूँ और मैं ये उचित नहीं समझता हूँ कि इनको यहाँ से शिफ्ट करना है. ये हमारा हम ऐसे नहीं काम करते हैं. इंडियन आर्मी में हमारे पास एक आ गया है एक बार और उनका हमारा जो ईथोस है हमारा जो फंक्शनिंग है उसी से वो हमारे जैसे मोटिवेट हो जाता है अगर मोटिवेट नहीं भी हो तो. और मेरे को किसी के ऊपर शक करने का कोई बिल्कुल आइडिया ही नहीं है. इवन नॉट इवन अ लिटिल आउट ऑफ डाउट आई हैव टू डाउट एनीबॉडी हु इज अंडर माय कमांड. आई फील आई एम क्वाइट कॉन्फिडेंट दैट आवर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज अ वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग बेस वी हैव एंड द ईथोस वी हैव. एनीबॉडी हु कम्स इन वी मोल्ड देम इनटू आवर सिस्टम एंड मोल्ड देम टू बी अ पैट्रियोटिक सोल्जर. सो वी रियली नीड टू नॉट रियली नीड टू वरी अबाउट.
Rajendra Singh Republic Team.
We all know they've since the time they started this cross-border terrorism, it is not being done by the terrorists and the terrorist masters. It is being done by the Pakistan Army and the ISI, who have been masterminding this not only in India but everywhere across the other neighbors also. They have been doing that. So therefore, and without their support, their training and the strategy, I don't think anything does work. If it is, it wouldn't have lasted so long. सबसे पहले तो जो आखिरी में आपने पूछा था कितने हैं, इनका नंबर कभी कम नहीं होता है. जो इनको ट्रेनिंग कैंप्स होते हैं और लंच बैच होते हैं जहाँ से इनको सीमा के अंदर पुश करते हैं. वो अगर साउथ ऑफ पीर पंजाल नॉर्थ ऑफ पीर पंजाल लेते हैं तो तकरीबन साउथ ऑफ पीर पंजाल 185 टू 220 एंड नॉर्थ ऑफ पीर पंजाल 195 टू 220 रहते हैं हमेशा उनको आगे भेजने के लिए. एक बार उनको पुश कर दिया उनको हमने एलिमिनेट भी कर दिया तो और पीछे से लोग और आ जाते हैं इस कैंप में. सो ये कभी बहुत कम होता है ऊपर नीचे 10-15 का होता है लेकिन अराउंड 200 टू 225 इज ऑलवेज देयर इन द बॉर्डर. दैट्स वन. एंड सेकेंड इज yes, infiltration does take place. You cannot say that we will endeavor is to ensure zero infiltration. That's our job. So we put our best. But the adversary also looks at ways and means to beat the system. So we constantly review our own deployment, number of people and other means to pick them up and we try everything. But we have considerable amount of reduction has taken place. I want to tell you all, in 2017, the number of attempts that was made is almost double the 2016. So therefore, when you make an attempt that much more double, your probability of getting in is that much more and also getting eliminated is more. That's one reason we have been able to eliminate more. And there are a lot of people who returned as well. We have proof for that.
Kashmir mein Lashkar attack karega और जम्मू प्रोविंस में जैश के लोग अटैक करेंगे, कितना बड़ा खतरा ये समझते हैं आप आने वाले दिनों में? और दूसरा छोटा सा सवाल ये भी है कि अलर्ट एक जारी किया गया था एजेंसीज की तरफ से कि पॉसिबिलिटी है कि टेरर अटैक पठानकोट से लेकर जम्मू हाईवे तक कहीं पर भी हो सकता है. उसके बावजूद भी सुजमा कैंप के भीतर आतंकी घुसे हैं और जिस इलाके से घुसे हैं वो पूरी की पूरी दीवार जो है वो टूटी हुई है और उसके ऊपर टीन लगी हुई है. वहाँ पर सुरक्षा की इतनी चौकसी क्यों नहीं थी? क्या कोई कमी ऐसी रहेगी है जिसके ऊपर जांच करने की जरूरत है?
आप लोग ना बहुत बहुत सवाल पूछ रहे हैं. सो कमिंग टू योर सेकंड पॉइंट, आई वुड लाइक टू कमेंट बिकॉज इट डजंट कम अंडर माय ज्यूरिसडिक्शन. इट इज कमिंग अंडर दिस सम अदर थिंग. बट आई वुड लाइक टू से दैट एनी इन्फिल्ट्रेशन, जो भी आप इन्फिल्ट्रेशन पर बोल रहे हैं आईबी के तरफ, ये अभी नया नहीं है. आप लोग ने देखा होगा ये एक साइक्लिक है. कभी 3 साल के बाद, कभी 4 साल के बाद. अभी अगर इसको गौर से देखते हैं तो कब करते हैं कि जब इनको वैली के अंदर प्रेशर, बॉर्डर के ऊपर प्रेशर, जब उन्होंने अपना मकसद नहीं पूरा कर पा रहे हैं, तब ये ऐसे सॉफ्ट टारगेट को आईबीओ यहाँ से आते हैं। सो दूसरा जो आप बोल रहे हैं जेनरिक, मैं बोल रहा हूँ दोबारा वही दोहरा रहा हूँ, हमारे पास इतने सारे यूनिट आर्मी के पास और इतने सारे फैले हुए हैं, इन सबको हम ऐसे माहौल से देख नहीं सकते हैं क्योंकि देर ऑल इन पीस। वी कैनॉट अफोर्ड टू पुट टू मेनी boots on the ground to look at this. We need to have a proper structure coming up and the technology to do it, so that we restrict the entry and only few sentries are looking at it. Rest the technology should do, so that our people are rested also, because when they come on the borders, they're 24/7. Every night you have got to be alert. It's not an easy thing to do, so you have to keep the boys motivated. So it's a taxing on the troops as well. So these are all being addressed, but to have a foolproof system in everywhere, because we don't know, today he does in Sanjwan, yesterday he did in Kalichak, and other day he did in Agnur. So it's all across. You cannot predict it. It comes in such long cycle. So therefore, it's a difficult thing that needs to be understood. Nobody wants to buy casualties. Everybody wants to avoid it. Yes, that's our intention. We'll do it. But if you do ask me this question, on the border or immediately in the border, yes, I will not accept a single lapse there, because you're supposed to be protected that way. But in the hinterland, you cannot have such a risk. It will take long time for us to build the infrastructure.
Yogesh Sagotra, Greater Kashmir.
I think I have not answered this question as well, the second part of it. But जैसे आप पूछ रहे हैं कि जकंदाबाद इट इज नॉट अंडर आवर कंट्रोल, वी डू नॉट चेक द चेक पोस्ट पर से इज नॉट विद द आर्मी, सो देयरफॉर इट इज द स्टेट मशीनरी विच इज देयर टू लुक आफ्टर ऑल दिस ड्रग कमिंग इनसाइड, इट इज नॉट, इट्स बियॉन्ड आवर पर्से, देयरफॉर आई विल नॉट एबल टू कमेंट ऑन दैट। बट यस, डेफिनेटली द ड्रग मेनेस इज बॉदर्स एवरी सिटीजन ऑफ द कंट्री। आई थिंक दैट्स वर्स्ट फॉर्म ऑफ danger that we can really look at in JNK. I think not only JNK, in other states as well, but if it is coming, everybody has to really play up to ensure that it doesn't take place. That's why. Yeah, please can tell me which are the other two questions. I'm sorry.
My first question is that what is army going to do to make the, that alienated youth in mainstream?
Okay, you stop now. See, army, we all know that when we want to take do the kinetic operations, we realize the importance of taking the people along. So you would have realized that if you're putting 50% of our effort into kinetic operation, we also put 50% of our effort into getting the people. The amount of reach out to the people, both in North and South Kashmir, by the troops of the Chinar Corps, I think it's phenomenal. Anyone who has been there would realize, whether it is sports, it's dramatics, it's a seminar, you name a thing, it has been organized during this entire year. And it is not confined to any one part of the Kashmir. It is spread all across, both in the build-up, in the cities and towns, and also in the peripheral areas of villages. Even so much so that the cricket team that played the league matches, I think our Indian cricketer Dhoni was kind enough to come and speak to those. It's all an initiative of the, because he is a territorial army officer, and he volunteered to come. So a lot of initiatives have been done. Yeah, and also we focus a lot on education as well. The amount of initiative that we have done to specialize our army people in schools, and also hone the skills and to make it a model in the JNK for people to really emulate, is on. And we teach the trainers, we train the trainers, we are building in more money into automation of the education system, so that you get the best, and skill development, the initiative that has been taken. So if a small organization with a limited budget, we can do. I think everyone needs to contribute. Why only look at either the state government or the Indian Army? See, I think the people in JNK, everyone should take up the cause and look at it. I'm sure we will all grow, and then we'll be able to find a solution to this.
Atif Sharma, the Tribune.